Many people are under the impression that the water which comes out of a plant is clean. This is a common misconception. The function of a plant is to make the water cleaner, but it's not clean enough to drink. It could be used in irrigation. What a plant is trying to do is simply speed up a process that would naturally occur given more time. This means that a plant can create water that is safe to enter back into the water system as it's so heavily diluted.
The river then continues the water purification, acting as a form of the fourth stage. As a historian, if you really want to understand the sensibilities of those who lived in the past, you must be like a novelist and get into the skin of your characters and think and feel as they do. You are asked to imagine what it's like to be a peasant in medieval times, asking the sort of questions a peasant might ask. What the writer is saying is that a historian needs imaginative sympathy with ordinary people in the past. A university is not a business. More precisely, a not-for-profit college or university is significantly different than a for-profit business. A university has no owners, it is a public trust. Without owners, it has no one to pay dividends to, and no one for whom it must maximize its profits. A business has a single overriding goal: the maximization of return for the owners. A university has a multiplicity of goals: to foster learning, to create knowledge, and to serve its community. Bolstered by the result of laboratory experiments, researchers dare to say that gaming might be mentally enriching. These scholars are the first to admit that games could be addictive, and indeed part of their research explores how games connect to the reward circuit of human beings. Particle accelerators produce and accelerate beams of charged particles, such as electrons, protons, and ions, of atomic and subatomic size. They are used not only in fundamental research for an improved understanding of matter, but also in plethora of socio-economic applications related to environmental monitoring, food quality, energy, and aerospace technologies. The role of women in promoting voluntary medical male circumcision uptake. Research reveals the important role played by women in influencing men to undergo circumcision. Women are also motivated to convince men to undergo male circumcision because of the benefits associated with them, such as reduction of HIV transmission and cervical cancer. Every few seconds, our eyelids automatically shutter and our eyeballs roll back in their sockets. So why doesn't blinking plunge us into intermittent darkness and light? New research shows that the brain works extra hard to stabilize our vision despite our fluttering eyes. When our eyeballs roll back in their sockets during a blink, they don't always return to the same spot when we reopen our eyes. This is a new, accessible and engaging textbook written by academics who also work as consultants with organizations undergoing change. It offers a unique combination of rigorous theoretical exploration together with practical insights from working with those who are actually responsible for managing change. Don't miss the very beginning of a lecture, since that is often the most valuable part. For instance, because it reviews previous lectures or outlines objectives and lecture structure. If you easily get distracted by other students, sit near the front. Particles can act like clumps of matter or ripple through space like waves, and they can even exist in two places at once. A new device harnesses this strange quantum behavior to measure Earth's gravity. Slight changes in gravity from place to place reveal changes in the density of material beneath the sensor. This allows the instrument to detect underground objects. As technology keeps growing, political and economic leaders have utilized cinema in changing and shaping people's outlooks either for their own benefit or for the benefit of the people. Quality translations are also readily available and extremely affordable for everyone these days, which makes it easy for filmmakers to reach their target audiences from all corners of the world in their mother tongue. Every few seconds, our eyelids automatically shutter and our eyeballs roll back in their sockets. So why doesn't blinking plunge us into intermittent darkness and light? New research shows that the brain works extra hard to stabilize our vision despite our fluttering eyes. When our eyeballs roll back in their sockets during a blink, they don't always return to the same spot when we reopen our eyes.